Hey guys, Kane here with another pickups video, and this is pickups for the month of September 2011. I got a few pickups, not as many as last time. I'm trying to cut back. Plus, since Christmas is coming around, there's a lot of great games coming out, and this video is going to be pretty quick because I just got Dark Souls in and I can't wait to crack that open and play it. It took UPS forever to deliver the damn thing. It's like 8:30 now. They didn't get here till like almost 8 o'clock. I was almost thinking it wasn't going to come today. So I had to listen to all my friends play the games. They got it from GameStop, and here I am waiting for my Amazon order to get shipped. But I finally got it, so I'm happy. Anyway, let's kick things off. I like to go to old and new. Let's start off with some PlayStation 2 games. I picked up two. First one's a game I saw on Replay Games in my hometown. And I haven't seen this game before. And I was surprised to see it. And I've been told it's probably the best Gundam game that ever came out over here in the States. And not counting, you know, the Dynasty Warriors series, but on the PS2, we should say. And that is Mobile Suit Gundam, Zionic Front. I'm a huge Gundam fan, but I did not know this game existed. I saw it sitting there on the shelf, and it was $6, and I was like, wow, I've never even heard of this game. I looked it up, couldn't really find much stuff on it. Picked it up, and played it for a little bit. It's actually pretty good. It plays like most of the Gundam games on the PS2, if you ever played them, like the Jaburo and stuff like that. It's a fun game. You control two different teams on the stages when you play them. You can switch back and forth, and it's kind of got a tactical element to it. But it's fun. It's good. It's a Gundam game, and I love Zeon. It's my favorite group in the whole Gundam series, so I'm hoping maybe you'll be able to unlock Char, Mobile Suit, and maybe play as Char. I'm not sure yet. Right now you play as like a rogue team that's not even in the timeline of the anime. But yeah, pick that up. Great fun. Picked this up off eBay. Got it for a really good price, and it's one of my top favorite games. And I've been wanting a sealed copy of it, and I found it, and that is Shin Megami Tensei's Persona 3, the first edition in the collector's edition box, still sealed. I've been wanting this for a while because I had Fez, so I was glad to be able to pick that up. Couldn't believe how cheap I got that. Next up, on to some PSP games. I picked up three this month. First off, I picked up Lunar Silver Star Harmony. I played the demo of this and really liked it a lot. I skipped on the collector's edition now, which I wouldn't have, because I really enjoyed it. And I haven't played the Lunar game since Sega CD. I never beat it either. I got stuck in one part and I didn't have the strategy guide. And back then, you know, you didn't have the internet, and it really bugged me. But I really liked the game a lot. It was one of the, probably one of my, besides Soul Feast, my favorite game I had on the Sega CD when I was younger. So I was glad to get this port. Never got it on the PS1, which I eventually will pick up. But I've always wanted to get back into the series, so glad to get that. Next up, another PSP game I've been wanting, and I decided to go ahead and get it. And that is Knights of the Dream. I love RPGs, and I heard this was a really good one. I love the artwork. I love a lot of games that Atlus produces anyway, so, or publishes, I should say. Which I think they might have actually produced this game as well, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, I love the cutscenes. I love the way it looks on the back. So I haven't read too much on it. I'm the type of person, I don't like to look up too much on games. I like to be completely, you know, surprised when I start playing it. Sometimes it's a good thing, sometimes it's a bad thing. That's just how I am. But glad to pick that up. Next up, I had to get this game. I'm kind of disappointed in a couple things, and I'll go into it, but I picked up Shin Megami Tensei Persona 2 Innocent Sin for the PSP. They finally brought this game over to the States. As you know, we got Persona 2, but we only got the second part, or the first part. And I can't remember if it was the first or the second part. I think it's the second part, but it could be the first. I can't remember. Anyway, I have to look it up. But anyway, Innocent Sin never came over to the States, and this is finally a port of it, which is a remake. Couple complaints. First, the Persona 1 Collector's Edition came with a 2-disc soundtrack, which was awesome. I think it had like 65 songs on it. But this one only came with 10 songs on 1-disc soundtrack, which is kind of disappointing. for them to go from the two-disc soundtrack to just the one-disc soundtrack. Another thing that's really disappointing, and it came out in Japan like this as well, is they pretty much took out anything Nazi-related in the game, which is what intrigued me. I'm not like a Nazi or anything, but I think it was kind of cool that they had Hitler in there and things like that. But apparently, from what I've read, they've switched out the swastikas for iron crosses, and they completely changed Hitler. They took his name out and they put him as the Führer, which is okay. But I heard they put black sunglasses on his face, and they put a coat on him to cover up his outfit, which is, I mean, really? Really, are we that? I mean, are people really suing over this? I mean, it's a game. I mean, it just kind of ruins it that you can't just express yourself anymore without being worried that you're going to get sued or piss a certain group off. It's a fucking game. Just kills me. I guess I can understand why they did it, but again, it sucks. I mean, I think it's cool having Hitler and stuff in there, but I guess they didn't want to piss the wrong people off, or maybe those people threatened and said, hey, don't put this in here. And usually the people that do that don't even play video games anyway. And it kind of ruins it for everyone who does play it, has an imagination, and doesn't think, oh, you know, Nazis are great people, I mean. But still, glad to pick it up. Can't wait to play through it. I'm kind of disappointed of the changes, because I thought that was really cool and unique about the game that made it kind of dark and twisted. But I guess eventually I'll get around to playing it, and I'll see for myself if it's still, you know, worth playing, which I'm sure it is. Next up, I picked up three DS games, and two of them I couldn't believe that I found. I was really excited when I went into GameStop and saw them, because they're impossible to find and they're in excellent condition. I'm guessing whoever owned them turned them both in. But it's Castlevania Dawn of Sorrows. I've been looking for this game forever, but I didn't want to pay the eBay prices. Plus, you don't know what it really looks like. You know, a lot of them didn't look like they were in great condition, but this is in excellent condition. And of course, everything I buy is complete, so all the goodies are in there. So I'm glad to get that. And then I also was able to get Portrait of Ruin. It was right beside it. And I got both of these for $14, which is a great deal if you ask me. And when these games came out, I wanted them. And I was out of handheld. I was like, I'll never buy a handheld again. And then I finally recently bought a handheld again. So now I'm trying to pick up all these games that I wanted back in the day that I didn't get. I'm a huge Castlevania fan, so I'm really glad to grab that. Now I just need one more DS game, Castlevania game, and I'll have them all. Next, I got this game with Lunar. Amazon was having a buy one game, get one game 50% off. So I got this game for like $9. And I've been wanting this game for a while, but I'm not a fan of how they've changed things. But it's my favorite Final Fantasy game ever made, so you probably already know what it is. So I had to get it, and that was Final Fantasy IV. So definitely picked that up. Got it for a steal of price, so not complaining. Next up is my PS3 games. And I picked up 6 PS3 games this month. First off, I picked up, it's funny, I had this game once already, and I sold it to a friend and I regretted it, so I re-picked it up again because I want to have it in my collection. I might want to play it again. And that's Valkyria Chronicles. My friend, at the time, it's really hard to find this game, so when I saw it in GameStop again, I grabbed it real quick. But I sold this game about a year or two ago to a friend because he was wanting it and he couldn't find it anywhere. And I miss having it. Finally, I found a copy, so I grabbed it. So I'm glad to have that game back. Next, I picked up White Knight Chronicles 2, which I've been absolutely loving. I haven't played it in a couple of days because some other games have came out here recently, and I'll show you that I've been playing the hell out of. And but it's a really good game. Plays a lot like, it feels like a mixture of Final Fantasy XI and, you know, some elements of like Final Fantasy XII and stuff about, you know, it feels like that type of game. So, really cool game, really fun. It also has the first game with it, so if you missed out on the first game, you know, it's definitely worth picking up. And, you know, the voice acting, my friend was saying, is really bad. I haven't gotten really that far in the game. Maybe I'm about 2 hours in it. But he says, when I get to the frog part, I'll understand what he's talking about. So, it kind of scares me, talking about frog people talking, but Anyway, so far I'm actually really enjoying the game. It's pretty fun. If you like grinding and MMO type RPGs, if you like Final Fantasy XII, you'll probably like this game. So, cool to pick up. Next, I got the Ico and Shadows of Colossus collection. Shadows of Colossus is one of my top five favorite games of all time. And I've already beaten it twice. I actually beat on this one. I'm a trophy hoarder this game. I'm really not a huge trophy person, but I love these games. It's giving me a reason to play these games again. So I'm gonna try to collect all the trophies on them just to give me some reason to keep playing it because I love it so much. And it's actually an amazing port. I was really worried that it wasn't going to be. I bought the God of War edition, and it was pretty much the same as owning God of War on the PS2 in progressive scan. And I knew these games were progressive scan as well because I owned them, but it actually looks really, really good. I was really surprised, and the surround sound is amazing on it. And to have the trophy support on top of that gives me a reason to play back through it. But I beat it the other day over at my friend Dave's house. He was like, hey, you want to play some Shadows of Colossus? And I just started knocking it out. And, you know, I played the game so much, I can beat it in about 4 hours. So I beat the whole game over there while they watched, and it was pretty fun. They played me some montage music to get me pumped up for the final battle, a little bit of Rocky IV music there. But, yeah, it's a great game. Awesome. Love it. Glad to have it. Must have. Next. It's an import game I got with a PS3 I just bought, and that is Tales of Exilia, or Tales of Siren, or whatever it's called. Awesome Tales game, I love it a lot. Been following a guy on YouTube who's doing a walkthrough with it to translate a little bit for me. But I'm going to buy it. I'm pretty positive this is going to come out in North America. It's an awesome game. I actually love it a little bit better than Graces, though I haven't played Graces F too much, just a demo. But do I love it more than Vesperia? Probably not, but then again, I haven't, you know, heard the, I really don't know the story too well. I've only played it for about 3 or 4 hours. But it's actually a really good game, really fun. Plays just like Tales of Vesperia. So if you play that, you'll really enjoy it. Good game, I definitely recommend importing it. I think in 2-3 more years, we might see it in North America, at least if you don't want to wait that long. I would import it. It's a pretty amazing game. I like it a lot. As far as the PS3 goes, I didn't want to throw it in this video and show up, but I took some videos of it, so I'll talk about it a little bit. It came in a really nice, cute box, and it also came with a brand new type of controller. It's actually not glossy like the black PS3 controllers. It's a matte black. I'm not sure if that's a new thing moving forward for PS3s in general, but it came with a flat black controller. Which, you know, it doesn't bother me too much. I'm not even going to use a controller anyway because I have like 7 PS3 controllers already. But I really love this PlayStation 3 a lot. It's really sleek. It's the new model. Supposedly it has less battery power consumption and things like that. But it looks just like the new model PS3s. And I just love the designs on the top and everything like that. It just looks really amazing. And it also came with a little... anyone who pre-ordered the game off PlayAsia or the console got this little free like Chiba keychain, and it was 4 or 5 different figures, and you don't know who you got, characters I should say, and I got Nelia, of course, which is pretty awesome. It's who I wanted. So I opened it up and looked at it. I had to see who I had. I wasn't going to open it, but I did. But I put it back in the box because I don't want to get it messed up or anything. But the PS3 looks absolutely amazing. Really, really happy to have it. Also, at the time, I went ahead and picked up the Tales of Exilia 15th, well, Tales of 15th Anniversary collection book, which has a ton of great artwork, and I'm really happy to pick that up as well. It just has a bunch of, you know, different characters, information on each character, each cover art for the games, when they were released, an encyclopedia with references to stuff in all the games and things like that. So it's really cool to have, and I'll post a little video of it up on here going through it. But yeah, I'm really happy to get that awesome find. And also I want to take a moment to just show this real quick in the actual case inside of it, because it has the 15th on it. It has this really cool, I'm not sure if all the games do this, because I know they released some PSP ones for this, but it has this little really sweet timeline of when all the Tales of games were released. So I thought that was really cool that they did that and added that in there. So that was pretty awesome of them. Alright. Next up, I picked up another Disgaea 4. Wanted to have one sealed, so I picked this up. Now this one didn't come, I didn't get another set of 9 figures, but this does come with the art book and the Fuka figure and whatever. I just wanted it sealed because I'm not gonna open up my 9 figure set anyway. And it wasn't packaged in together with this, so. And I didn't open up my soundtrack either, which again was exclusive to NIS America's website. And the last game that I picked up was Arcania Hearts 3 for the PlayStation 3. This is the limited edition from the UK. Pretty odd. Look at that box art, man. Goodness. Fan service all day. But this is a really cool fighter game made by Access Games. And it's fun. I haven't played it too much. I downloaded it on PSN because I didn't want to open up my box art, because they only released 4,000 of these, so they're pretty exclusive. And it comes with, you know, the game and a 444 page art book, comes with the soundtrack, and then it comes with these character 12 character guide cards. It's almost like a movie list and stuff. But the boxes, it's a heavy box, I tell you. For having the game, the soundtrack, and those 12 cards with the art book, I mean, that art book must be a hardcover, but I mean, it's heavy. I mean, it's at least three pounds or more, but I'm glad to get it. Not gonna open it, just collector purposes. I really like the way it looked. I was debating on getting it or not because it cost about $90, but when I saw that it was, you know, the box art looked really cool and stuff, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna grab it. But I probably want to open it again. Like I said, I downloaded it on PSN, so. But anyway, that's it for the pickup videos for September. Anyway, gonna go play some Dark Souls. Thanks for watching, guys.